May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, that was another long gospel. This one was an entire chapter. So well done, hanging in there. Now, this may not be an issue for you, but for me, when readings are this long, I have a hard time staying focused, no matter how hard I try. So I'm not sure how you all did with it, but I want to give you a Cliff Notes version of what this gospel is saying. So Jesus is walking along and he encounters this blind man who's a beggar, and the disciples asked him, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? And Jesus tells them, this is not about sin, but because this man is blind, they're going to have an opportunity to witness what God is all about. So Jesus spits on the ground, makes some mud, and puts it on the blind man's eyes, and tells him to go and wash in the pool of Siloam. And he does so, and he receives his sight. Then people start asking questions. What happened? How has this blind beggar received his sight? And to make matters worse, Jesus has done this on the Sabbath, and no work is to be done on the Sabbath. So the religious leaders, which you may hear as the Jews or as the Pharisees, those leaders, the crowds, were upset about this, and they didn't believe what had happened. So then there's this back and forth. There's interviews with a man who received his sight. There's interviews with his parents trying to get to the bottom of what's really going on. And eventually, they just give up. They say they do not know where Jesus is from, and the man's testimony upsets them so much that they drive him out. The chapter ends with Jesus saying, I came into the world so that those who do not see will see, and those who do see will be blind. The religious leaders question this, and Jesus says, if you were blind, you would not have sinned. But because you say, we see, your sin remains. Now, these are some odd things that Jesus is saying. I don't believe he is speaking about physical blindness. I believe he is speaking about spiritual blindness. He is telling the religious leaders they are unable to see what is right before their eyes. They are indeed blind. And we can testify to their blindness. You've just stood through this long chapter being read. Imagine if after the blind man had received his sight, the crowd would have said something like, wow, that's great, thanks, Jesus. Then the chapter would have been a heck of a lot shorter. So before I go on, I want to do a little experiment with you, which requires your participation. Are you up for this?
Sure.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So what I want you to do is stand up and find somebody in this room that you don't know well or have never met before. And I want you to ask them a very innocuous question. I want you to ask them what has been the highlight of their weekend so far. And ask each other, introduce yourselves, ask each other, and then come back to your seat. It can be very brief. All right, so stand up. Find someone you don't know or don't know well. Cannot be someone in your family.